Alright guys, we can go ahead and get started. But first off, let me call out the new people on the couch who followed over the last week. Rhianna Marie, Devin Rue, and Ward's Magical Wares. Always nice to see you people. So I actually remembered to go and download the DLC that I own. So let's do all of that really quick. Really quickly. Any new tricks he's learned? Most of this is going to be pretty useless to us right now.
The armory is at your disposal.
But there is the champion hammer, which is probably going to be most useful to us on this hero good boy run. Yeah, let's take that.
He's convinced he can bring them all to life.
Nice to see you again.
So last we left off, we met Reaver, our wonderful, wonderful friend from the previous game, who is still evil AF, but a lot younger. Looks like with all of his factory workers, he can definitely get a lot more sacrifices to the Court of Shadows. Shadow Court. So we need to go
right. This should be the place.
The sewers.
Somewhere beyond this door is the base of the Bowerstone Resistance. Ready when you are.
And meet up with the Bowerstone Resistance. Because our brother sucks.
I really love how much time we're spending in caves and sewers these days. No, really. I should warn you. I don't know what kind of reception we'll get. I know their leader well enough, but it was never safe for me to come down and meet the rest of them, and they're not exactly the most trusting of people.
So just a recap, Walter, claustrophobic AF. And us, sketchy AF.
Hello! Hello! Maybe we've got the wrong place. Let's, get out. Don't move!
Why, hello.
We won't move if you won't shoot. Deal?
You'd better tell your friend that.
It's all right. Just do as he says.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
I'm Walter, and this is... That really doesn't matter right now. We're here to speak with Paige.
I say
that's right, we still don't have a name.
We're on your side. Just hear us out.
We don't make deals with spies. Shoot!
Wait!
Put your weapons down. I thought I gave the orders around here, kid.
Sorry, Paige. Got a bit carried away.
Walter, glad you're all right.
And I'm glad you came in when you did.
I wasn't exactly expecting you. Let's talk somewhere a bit more private.
We'll get a little bit of privacy with Paige. Paige is cool. I love her.
I had this whole plan, you see. But I... Well, we ended up leaving the castle earlier than I thought.
I heard. Pity. Your messages were always useful.
I can offer you something better.
That's me.
Paige, I'd like you to meet.
I know who she is. I thought you'd know better than to bring the princess here.
She's not just a princess. She's a hero.
Great. Give her a medal.
No, I mean, she's a hero. like her mother.
Right, really? Capital H heroes.
It doesn't change anything. Your brother is the reason we
people who
the
have
ground.
A bloodline who trace back to the Archon of the First Kingdom, the Old Kingdom.
It's not just me she needs to convince. The people of this city need someone they can believe in. Prove to them that they should follow you, then we'll talk. For now, I have work to do.
Looks like you have work to do, too. You have a whole city to inspire.
Ah. Hello, Teresa. So our sister from the very first game is still kicking a good 650 years later.
Today you have met the true voice of the people of the city. It is imperative that you win Paige and her resistance movement to your cause. And just as important that you prove to Bowerstone that you can be its rightful ruler.
Open the gates! Right, so we can get, lots of stuff right now. I haven't really been doing any jobs. So, I don't know if I'll be using any of those. Right now, I'm gonna focus on the right side. Shit. Let's focus on our guns. That looks like it's the only thing we're going to be able to do until we do some more quests. Let's go ahead and do that.
It would seem your heroism has to be put to the test once again, madam. May I suggest...
Unless I am mistaken, you need to inspire more people to follow you. What about undertaking some quests? People love quests.
People do love quests. So we've got a lot of them that we can do. And actually right now we can go to Silver Pines. My favorite area for obvious reasons. But there's actually this quest, the Silver Pines Curse, that I haven't done yet. In any playthrough. But for now, what can we do? What can we do? There's a very small pupper outside, just as vicious as ever. Yeah. Let's go back and let's do the fetch quest. This guy needs an escort.
I'm a wandering trader trying to get to Brightwood
cool,
Village.
We'll help you.
But you'll take me? Thank you. I'll make it worth the trouble. Really, I will.
We gotta hold hands and bring him all the way to Brightwall.
I've been a wandering trader all my life. My mother was too. Couldn't tell you who my father was. Nor could my mother, actually.
So our dog is wonderful and will always find us stuff. And actually, because of some free DLC, I can... actually, it might not be free. But I can make him a 5-star dog instantly. Because we kind of need him to be.
What's the
a 5-star
hold
dog.
Up? Let's be on our way.
Only the best boy. Cool, he's
What's
the goodest boy
the
now.
Up?
So he'll help
Let's
us do
be
a
on
lot.
Our way.
Come on, Billy. Yes, our dog is an expert at tracking down hidden items. Love him.
It's almost certain that we'll get attacked by bandits.
Dwarf.
Renegades! Don't let them kill me! I'm a bit jumpy.
Watch out, boy! She's got a gun, and she knows how to use it. Nobody knocks without my mates, but me!
Beat up a monster!
Ooh, my tattoos are starting to glow. Come on, Pupper.
I'm ready when you are.
That's the one thing, the pathing in this game is not improved.
My hands are shaking. I'm ready when you are. Let's go. I don't know how to use that safely.
All right, Billy.
Nice. To live in anyway, buying stuff in one place, selling it in another.
So that was one of the hidden quote-unquote jobs that you could do in Fable 2 and also this game, is you can be a wandering trader. Actually, you could do it in the first game too.
Keep your eyes peeled for renegades and bandits.
And that was actually the only job in the first game besides actually questing. Paying attention to the economies in certain areas, buying things whenever there's a surplus,
Renegades!
Selling them whenever there's a shortage.
Hey, get off your ass and back in the fight!
So the reason I'm putting so much effort into using flourishes is because one of my weapons, the Bone Smasher gun, that's one of the, I want to say parameters, but that's not the word, prerequisites for getting it to morph, and I think getting a shotgun blast. Alright, that's some bullshit. So even with flourishing, these enemies can block. And that was supposed to be the one reason to use flourishing over anything else. Come on.
I read a book the other day by some bloke called Dan Smoria. What rubbish it was.
Actually don't know what book he's referring to.
I'm ready when you are. Let's go. Wow, you're really good at that, aren't you? Stop them before they kill us both.
There we go.
Yippee!
Ooh. Fine stuff.
feel the call of the open road? Eventually, I hope to open a more permanent shop. Billy's Bazaar of the Bazaar. I thought I'd call it. Just need to get some weird goods and that to justify
Billy's Bazaar of the Bazaar.
I love
Babe.
The life of a wandering trader.
Steal that for your D&D campaign.
Much, well, wandering. Bit of trading as well. Okay. See you around. We've made it. Thank you. Here's a little something for you. Oh, and come back later if you like, when I've got my stall set up. I'll give you a good price.
Hey, we did one of the very, very small 5 guild seal quests in the game. Lovely. There's another one, it's a demon door, but I don't have a lot of expressions. Yeah, it doesn't look like there's anything else there, but... Let's at least start the Penance Mightier. And let's at least just activate all the quests around here. So the Penance Mightier is actually one of the few books that's in Fable 2.
Stamp my renewal! It's you! Oh, thank the gods of documentation!
The gods of documentation!
The Academy will continue to grow. Of course, it will still be closed by royal decree.
Penance Mightier might have also been in Fable 1. I don't remember if that was an actual quest or just...
And I will give it a good home.
No, it was just something
I know
you could
of several do. That exist and have already prepared displays for them.
Okay, we did it. We're definitely going to do the Marriage of Inconvenience.
The Sanctuary Shop has.
Yeah.
Please, my sweet, please, I'm so sorry. I'll make it up to you.
I've heard that before. And the first few times you disappointed me, your clumsiness was sort of adorable in its way. But it's got a bit tired, hasn't it?
My darling, please don't. I'm sorry. Please, let's not argue. It's so awful.
So their sexes will actually change depending on whether
you're
playing as the prince or the
princess.
Oh, when I married my husband, he was all sweetness and smiles. And now he's all bitterness and vile. He bullies me. He berates me. It's horrible. He's horrible. But if I divorced him, he'd get half my fortune, which is quite a bit of money. Oh, I wish I was someone else. Wait, what if he was with someone else? If a girl like you were to approach him, chat him up, tell him you've got more money than I do, he divorced
we have
me to marry
no money.
You, and I'd be free and clear. Oh, of course, you wouldn't actually have to marry him. Once he's divorced me, you could just walk away. Oh, I'd love to see the look on his face then. I know it sounds repugnant, but this could be my only way out. Will you do it?
Of course.
You'll do it? Oh, this is the first good thing that's happened to me in years.
What is it now? Don't tell me you want to talk about things. Oh, sorry. I thought you were my wife. Mm-hmm. Don't know how I could have confused someone like you for someone like her. So, what can I do for you?
Let's interact with him.
Oh, you're a saucy one, aren't you? I like it. You're all right, I suppose? Oh, hello.
They're a lot more tactile with the expressions in this game.
Nice moves. Alligator.
Go on, let's go. We are strong.
Well, beautiful, you're quite a bit of fun, aren't you? Much more diverting than that wife of mine. Do you know, she spends all her time reading or gardening. So dull. I can't remember the last time she did something thrilling for me. Like, buy me a ruby. I adore rubies, by the way.
Wow, let's, give him a ruby that we dug up.
Look at that. You spared no expense. Thank you.
Because we are still broke AF.
You've got my...
All in love with patty cake.
This takes me back.
Literal patty cake.
That was my pan around. So, what's on your mind, sweetheart?
You're the best, darling.
Hey, look, we made someone fall in love with us.
It's been lovely spending time with you. And it was exciting at first, flirting in my wife's house. But aren't you a bit bored? We should go somewhere. How about Brightwall Bridge?
Why, that's an excellent idea. Let's go over there right now. Yeah, so he'll like magnetize to me if we get a little too far away.
Your hand is like a vice of steel, my love. Impressive. Lovely view here, isn't it? And you don't ruin it with a lot of talk. You just stand there and look irresistible.
The silent protagonist.
Wow. You've done that before, I should think. That, or you have amazing instincts. I have to tell you, I've been with Wilma so long, I forgot how incredible it can feel to be with someone exciting. I want more.
What do you say? We make a go of this? I'll leave Wilma, and you and I can be together.
You've got a ring, you've got a house. You're going to be very hard to resist, aren't you?
Go ahead and ask, and let's see how strong my resistance is.
Will you marry me?
Yeah, yeah!
So, this is not our husbando? Not at all?
Now I just have to divorce Wilma. Oh, I wish I'd met you 5 years ago. Would have spared myself a lot of crushing boredom.
Finally, a little money coming into
this town. He is not the Alex of this game, even though he kind of is. It's kind of inconvenient how you have to go through someone else's yard to get to your own house. You okay?
I've got news for you, Wilma. You're not going to like it, and let me tell you, that breaks my heart, truly. I've decided we're not right for each other. More specifically, you're not right for me. So, here are the divorce papers. You may consider yourself an ex-wife.
Vincent, I don't know what to say. Other than, thank you. Thank you for doing just what I knew you would.
What? You planned this all along?
Sorry to say. I'll file these with the city clerk first thing tomorrow morning, and then we are officially history. Thanks again.
Well, my enterprising love, aren't you a piece of work? You make a deal with a housewife to split up her marriage and leave her husband penniless. Rather underhanded, I would say. I wonder, just how despicable are you willing to be? Because if I think this through logically, if she never makes it to that office, the divorce never happens. And then instead of marrying a hot-blooded divorcee, you'd be landing yourself a very wealthy widower.
What? You can't mean... You'd kill me!
Well, technically, she'd kill you. I'm sorry.
So we are playing the good boy run. A lot of money. Or good girl run.
You haven't left me much of a choice.
Don't listen to him. You can just walk away.
This is technically the good part of it. To just split them up.
Don't go.
You have saved Wilma from a face worse than marriage. We got 20 guild seals, which is not...
Jam-tart. You're not really going to divorce your true love.
Not a small amount.
You're unbelievable. You just tried to have me killed, and now you're trying to worm your way back into my heart.
I was confused. This whole awful affair has reminded me how much I really love you. Let's just tear up those papers and start again, And as long as we're tearing, maybe we should have at these clothes as well.
Have it? Get out of my house!
Well, all right. Fine. Well, you're a disappointment, Wilma. I wanted to make it work, but if you don't want to try, I'll leave. And I'm taking my movies with me.
Fine.
Same. All right, so that's been done. Oh, we have enough to open something. I don't think we have 60 quite yet. Nah. We'll go ahead and get these expressions. Nice.
Ah, hello.
One thing about making this a menu. It, does not work.
I stand ready to serve. Your new garments are ready, should you want them.
All right, I cannot interact with my map. Lovely. Oh, because I'm on the road to rule. Okay. Fine. brawn, not brains. There's still the chicken chaser thing that we can do. Let's go ahead and do that.
This is terrible. Somehow the gate got open, and all of my chickens have escaped. I don't know how they did it, those chickens, and maybe I never will. Chickens are extraordinarily clever.
Chickens are extraordinarily clever.
Right, you'll need this. Contrary to what most people think, chickens are very, very crafty.
You've a new suit in your wardrobe, a new feathery suit.
Yes, we do.
You're dressed as a chicken. What are you planning to do dressed as a chicken?
They won't fall for any of that. Come here, chicky chicky. I've got some lovely treats for you. Oh no, too smart. You have to defeat them psychologically. Now, they won't remain one concentrated force. They'll have redeployed into groups of three or so to maximize their tactical advantage. When you fight, flap your wings.
Okay, so our dog will actually find the chickens for us. But yeah, this is a thing.
Their reign of terror is over before it began. All right, see if you can.
At some point, they'll start like singing, which is always fun. And gotta love those frames per second.
Use the chicken suit to get them to follow you. It's a bit crazy, just crazy enough to work.
Oh, yeah, dig spot. I need a quest.
That outfit just doesn't work.
It's a great day to be alive. And a better day to kill.
Well, so we also found a gnome.
If I had a friend like you, I could tell them secrets. Like that I'm gonna set you on fire.
Yeah, so these are actually hyper intelligent chickens, apparently. Again, very disconcerting. Now that our dog is a 5-star dog, he's gonna find literally everything. It's gonna make the playthrough a little bit more slow pace, but
thanks for that, love. Nice doing business with you. I've got plenty of gold for drink. I just need some.
Terrific! We're gaining the initiative. Go on!
So they're headed back. So now we can try to find the last group. I think it's up here, I'm not entirely sure. Was it over here?
Seeing you brings back memories of wanting my eyes, Gavin.
Yeah, here they are. Come on, dog. Gotta love that 360 era pathing.
This is a once in a lifetime sale.
Cool, but now we can deliver these last three chickens and get those sweet guild seals and another follower.
Yeah, I'm good with faces, and I'm quite sure I don't remember yours.
That's all of them. At last, the tone can rest easy.
Oh, Bernard, you've got to lock them up again. This isn't right. They deserve to be free.
You're always on about the
right.
Chickens.
Good versus evil. We got to save them.
You know what I think?
Good boy.
I think it was
good boy,
you
run.
No.
You're right. I admit it. I couldn't live with myself any longer being complicit in this chicken oppression.
But they might have destroyed the entire town. Possibly the world.
They might have gone off to live peacefully on their own. They might have created great works of art or literature. We don't know. And we have no right to take away their fundamental liberties based on our own prejudices.
Well, now it's clear taking away their liberties isn't enough. I have to assume you'll try to facilitate another escape. And that means the only choice is to kill them all.
Alright, keep them locked up, at least so we can talk about this.
You infiltrated the chickens, you lived among them.
Ah yes,
you know
us, with our wonderful
What's
chicken powers,
it's a simple
having been raised by chickens.
Be killed.
No, Bernard, they're not like that.
Alright, we'll let them live, but only if you swear never to let them out again.
Alright. All right. We'll work this out.
I hope I haven't made a terrible mistake. But if I killed them, I would just make them martyred.
Your acts have made you a legend among chickens, assuming they possess any capacity for higher cognition, which they almost certainly don't.
Just don't know about this.
It's what's best, Bernard.
Alright, so we still have a couple of quests around here. These two we actually won't be able to complete. That's fine. Oh god. Pop Wars. Let's ask him to see what he wants. I honestly forgot.
Please, you've got to help me. I'm so worried. It's my daughter, you see. I can't find her. The little scamp is always going off on her own, having adventures and whatnot. Always comes back after a while, though, but this time she's been missing for hours and hours. I'm frantic with worry. It's all her father's fault. He never stops talking about how there's...
You actually do need to go to those caves anyway to get some gnomes.
Thank you so much. Please bring her back safe and sound as soon as you can.
For some reason I never come up here. I forgot what's actually up here. some ravens. Okay. We got some Prince gloves. Asperius Nuttuck. Asperius. Cool stuff.
Well.
More treasure. Oh, silver key. Nice. So we actually came here to see the demon door, but guess that's not happening. We're gonna go back to Miss B. And we'll be going into the cold caverns. Still dressed as chicken, because of course we are. Ooh, I'm about to get ganked. This is actually our first time coming back to the snowy part after our gnome friends have taken over. So we'll be seeing a lot of them.
Must be nice being able to lick your own privates. But doesn't that embarrass your dog? Think about puppies, about slowly crushing them. Oh, I love doggies. I love throwing them into the river in a sack.
Ah. Hello.
We could be best friends. If I like people with an ass for a face.
Ass face? No, there's no way around it. We're gonna have to go all the way around to get this guy. That's fine. So this is the path to the demon door. We might be able to do the demon door. I'm not entirely sure. No.
Sometimes I just want someone to talk to. And sometimes I want...
We got a dig spot. These rare items, I think we can only sell them.
A hero! I'm writing a book about a hero. Two, actually. Who go on a grand adventure and save the world. And along the way, learn something about life and love. And that's the tricky bit. The action is thrilling, the banter is punchy, but any scene where they express their feelings for one another falls a bit flat. I've nothing to draw inspiration from. I've asked passing villagers to express themselves to each other one-on-one. Most give me a weird look and hurry away. And the ones who indulge me, frankly, take
a... We're not actually going to be able to help them.
None of it helps. I don't want to see the crude, awkward fumblings of everyday folk.
No one loves us right now. And, yeah, none of these are quite the waifu slash husbando that I'm trying to see right now. Shine bright like a diamond. Wow, I hope this is taking us to the caverns and not the demon door. Yeah, we should be good. More Prince clothing. Nice. Cool, so I think this is a hot... No, this is a wolf cavern. And here I am, walking in, dressed as a chicken. A small child can wait. There is treasure. I figured a gnome would spawn, but maybe it's only on next runs. Gotta love the frames per second on the enemies. So for the standard child lost in dungeon, have to escort them out. This one's actually pretty tame, mostly because the enemies are literally the beetles of this game.
Are you one of those adventurers?
Why, yes we are. Awesome, so we're almost out. I think there are other caverns that we can go in and explore, but not until after we can drop this child off. I think in those caverns we can find, bones. That is brilliant. Except, guess what? There are even more wolves. What if you leave your house tonight and there are like three wolves waiting outside your door? They gonna like eat your titties and your pussy and your face and shit. That is little dicky. Hello, child. Gotta love this winter aesthetic, though.
I spy with my little eye something beginning with S.
Some succulent stones.
More nasty things! Don't let them eat me!
So unlike other escort missions, she is actually immortal. The child is fine. And we can flourish to our heart's desire without risking injury at all. Just losing all of our friends. Until I killed the child by accident. Cool stuff. The Albion girl always gets her way.
There's my mom! Mommy! Mommy!
My darling! My little darling! What a relief! I was beside myself! I can't thank you enough. I'm forever in your debt.
This really could not have gone any better. Oh, we can finally get a mule fields. That's good. it's daylight. So we can go back to Morningwood. We can't do peace, love, and homicide, because this is good boy. We can do bored to death, though. So those of you who joined me on the Fable 2 run, nobody in chat right now, obviously. But in Archive Land, you might remember Max and Sam. Max and Sam being the two boys from Bowerstone who found the Necronomicon and unleashed lots of nasty things on Bowerstone and Bloodstone. And yeah, 50 years later, 60 years later, no 50, they're still kicking, somewhat.
You said this cemetery would be loads of fun, and now it's obvious you were talking bollocks. Well, I'm not getting it. Have Livy here get it.
Who?
Oh, right. What about it?
So our mother helped
ever
them
so
out.
Grateful.
Although
this is no
she
ordinary
was
book. It's the Normanomicon. It can summon the dead. Well, that
well,
makes
she
it
was
sound so insidious. We don't want to do anything diabolical.
She became the one she always knew she
just
was.
Just want someone to have a chat with. Ah, genius! Problem solved.
Now, the thing is, the book is in Millfields.
Our mum's got it. She always said she'd take it to her grave.
Which she did.
You'll have that book over my dead body, she used to say.
Which was eerily prescient.
So all you have to do is dig it up.
And that's what we'll do. Shit, we don't need to be here. Although, we can get a spell, but no, we don't need that. I keep getting confused about the Guild Seal since that's how you access the quest menu in like the first one and the second one. Map for that in this one.
A little something new has appeared in the.
So Millfields is now what used to be Bowerstone or Bower Lake. It is a really cool area. And yeah, we're going to go there because it has a lot of things there that are very interesting. Y'all might already recognize this from our last excursion here. Yeah, so get here from Bowerstone Market. This is the same road that, essentially we never loaded in Fable 2. But yeah, there are fields, there are mills, that's all I need to know. and I'm still a chicken. Well, this section of the town looks kind of ominous. Wonder why that might be. So we're gonna be ambushed here a lot. This little road is probably my least favorite area in the entire game, sans the whole. Which actually exits here. Well, it doesn't exit here, but this was the other part of that cell. Now the monorail's down, and Reaver's not gonna fix it. No one's gonna use this. There's still one or two treasures lying around. Looks like one fell on this side too. No, that's a boat. Hey, 1,000 gold. We might have enough money to start buying a house. I'd like to start buying the dweller camp first, because they're definitely the cheapest.
Home is where the heart is, as they say. It should also be where you have your best furnishings. Now, have you given any thought to redecorating?
One of the things in this game that's new and kind of a nuisance, but it's fine, is repair. So every house is going to have a condition. All these houses are in terrible condition. But over time they will degrade and you actually have to invest money to maintain them. It's kind of upsetting.
Oh.
I think there's a quality of life thing in the menu to just repair them all, but I know there's one to raise and lower the rent. But I don't think there's any consequence for not doing it. Correct me if I'm wrong. But it's definitely better to keep the houses maintained. Good life advice, to be honest. I only have like a couple weeks before I move, and you won't be hearing small doggo anymore. There should just be a lot of quality of life improvements for the stream. Yeah, definitely looking forward to that. Let me just barrel roll all the way over to these guys. Get some area of effect. Immediately start pushing. Those bats are probably about to fuck me up. Gotta love those cinematic shots, even though they do literally nothing. Gotta love those 1,000 gold finds. I should probably, like, be immediately investing that in real estate so I can keep getting the most money. Those bats came for me. No, don't come for me. Look at that key. So this is literally just the Hob Cave that's adjacent to the monorail station. Nothing of actual lore here. And since this looks like it's going to be a pretty silent stream, I'm probably just going to keep doing all the menial tasks and not really focus on any lore. So I think I'll save Understone for a more active time. Maybe later in the stream? I don't know. I do know I know my mods are currently in New York City.
I'm not like those mean gnomes. I'm a million times worse.
With our wonderful ginger venture.
I'd
They'll be streaming tomorrow on twitch.tv/thesilentfan96. Should be fun. I won't be able to tune in for the most part because I'll be playing D&D, but Spot was near. He alerts whenever I'm over there. I'll say what this game lacks in gameplay and does it? I do love the like landscapes and setting. Like, this is definitely the best looking Albion once you get out of like the industrial parts. You hear that nice remix of the Bowerstone or Bower Lake remix soundtrack. Words are hard. Since her sons are also here, she is no longer at peace. So we found the Normanomicon, which is the book that summoned all the Hollow Men from the last game.
Here! What are you doing to my... Oh no, the book!
And guess what it does here? I'm glad Mrs. Spade gets a more prominent role, at least in this side quest, because she was honestly one of the best characters in Fable 2. McAfee, what's she doing? Lots of noises in my apartment complex today. Damn. I mean, pretty soon, I'm gonna be able to start getting Bone Smasher upgraded. But no. melee combat just doesn't work. I don't understand it.
Well, I haven't seen that kind of fighting since that hero rescued my son so many years ago. Twice.
Our mother.
Perhaps you should keep that book. With your skills, it will be safer with you than in my grave. And it's a bit uncomfortable, frankly.
Aww.
Well, I suppose I'll get back in then. If you see my sons, tell them they'd better be back here by supper if they know what's good for them.
Spending all the years of your young life on a small farm in a backwater county has made you restless. Who knows what flight of fancy or idle daydream first sparked your desire for adventure? But once ignited, the flames of wanderlust could not be extinguished, not even by the water of looking at things in more realistic terms, and perhaps considering a career in excavation. Your parents tried to listen, but the protests of the old ring hollow in the ears of a strong-willed young farm boy. It's a nice one, with newly painted signs and a bench. If you want to head east...
So what I immediately want to do is I want to go over here, closer to where the Romani camp was in the first game,
to head north towards the snow-covered mountains,
and restore bridge, because that's going to give us access to a really cool new place. If you want to go south,
which is back home, read this page again.
And here we are. Yeah, so this is... literally polygon by polygon the way to
please allow me to introduce myself
the way to the Romani camp from the first game. This will actually open a place called Driftwood.
Another victory for the Albion Historical Restoration Society. Come back later on once the bridge has been built.
What we can do now, however, let's go a little bit further to where Brightwood would have been. We can't actually access Brightwood.
Don't kill me! I beg you!
Oi! Leave him alone! He's a friend of mine!
What a thrust! Done with such skill!
Of course, we still get the god-awful bandit spawns that we did near the Brightwood entrance. What I want to do is actually go to this path.
Okay.
Oh, I see what you did, Reaver. So Reaver literally built his mansion right next to... That's Reaver's mansion, by the way. He built it right next to Hero Hill. Here lies Hero Hill. Yeah, lots of not fun stuff happened to Hero Hill. But it plays literally no part in this game, so there's no real need to access it. $400 gold. Let's There's not a lot that we can actually find swimming around. I do want to check under the bridge. Just to be thorough. While I'm not wasting anybody's time. Yeah. Yeah, we're broke as hell. All this money is actually helping us.
Welcome to.
We're not going to be able to buy anything here. Yeah, I think we should just keep buying Dweller Camp. Oh, reliable. The slaughterhouse. Cool stuff.
Fancy a delivery job? I've got a letter that simply must reach Brightwall as soon as possible.
That's Arthur. We've actually seen a couple of notes from him. He wants to insult everybody in Albion. And we will help him do that.
Fancy a delivery job? Excellent!
He's very happy to be rid of it.
Steel and will. You drive your enemies before you, but the true enemy who enslaves us all cannot be slain. What am I speaking of? Beauty. It is an artificial construct employed as a tool to oppress women and maintain the power of the patriarchal hegemony. Wait, is it patriarchal or matri- What's the one where the
down with the patriarchy.
They always laughed at me when I'd get it wrong at the empowerment rallies. Especially that Barbara. She was so cruel. Oh, the point is, we have been enslaved. And you know who's behind it all? Big fashion. The tailors, with their blouses and their hosiery and their straight-cut, reverse-pleat, broad-fall, natural-drape trousers. It's gone on far too long. The time for rebellion is
here. I'm currently dressed up as a chicken.
You will not be defeated by force of arms.
I am already going down with the patriarchy and big fashion.
Beautifulness. One brave pioneer could inspire countless others to rise against the tyranny of conformity. And they'd get a nice prize from me, too.
Any other business to attend to? Some new garments have been added to your wardrobe. A very nice combination. Few
Feel free to change the color of your clothes.
So I think if we just mix match everything, it'll be fine.
Ah, excellent. I can think of no finer skirt you could choose. Although, I could check in the back. No. I believe everything we have is out. I can think of no finer garment than those gloves for bashing a fellow's face in. You can't go wrong with a helmet, especially when walking underneath unstable things.
Yeah, this should be fine.
You're much too nice looking. You're doing just what they want.
Please, sir, am I ugly?
Ah, hello. I trust you are finding everything all right.
I know there is an ugly set. I don't know how to actually access it.
Not the usual sort of ensemble for one of your gender, but then who am I to judge? Very good. You look positively Aurora. Reconsider, have
you? It's probably actually too nice.
Magnificent selection. The headscarf is particularly well chosen. You know, what would go perfectly with those gloves is a riding crop or a... generals use them to point to maps. Swagger stick. That's it. Swagger stick. Swagger stick. Such a deliciously staccato... Nice gloves.
Or, you know, a riding crop.
All dressed up, I see. To join the circus, perhaps? That outfit is fantastic.
Am I ugly? I'm ugly, Mr. Krabs. Okay. I don't want to actually look up how to do that, so we will just be on our merry way.
Some things never go out of fashion. Well, I think that may have, but it looks comfortable. You do look the image of a mercenary. May have something to do with the fact that you're dressed as one.
Oh.
Well, that is a more traditional look. Ah, that is a good style. Makes a statement, but it isn't too, what's the phrase? In your face.
I really like this. Okay, so we will just put on a nice arm tattoo. Just balance. Well, balance.
I once knew a girl with a...
We're never going to tear down the establishment at this rate.
Cool. Let's go back to Max and Sam. They're in Millfield.
Welcome to...
Morningwood. Is that still the name?
Oh,
I've got to be close to upgrading at least one thing on this gun. Someday.
What should we do? Be bold. What if the page we open to is just the continuation of the previous page?
All right, if that happens, we'll flip back until we find the beginning of the section, but we'll do it boldly. Did you find the book in Mum's grave? We've got it! Now, let's see what's in here. Ghost pantry? Must be where the snacks are kept. Ghost pants? That sounds interesting.
Yeah, maybe a bit too interesting, at least to start with. What else?
Ghost party! Brilliant!
Right, let's have that then.
Now then, Necrus Risius Cordroy!
Ghost party. Oh dear. We have helped the deceased duo obtain the Normanomicon. Not one of our better judgment calls. Slowly but surely, we are getting enough guild seals. $70 is actually enough for us to get something. It's still daylight. At night, we're gonna do the sun. I don't want to do the sunset house on this stream. I might just make this one a short one.
Oh, it's you again. The one that convinced us to keep the chickens.
Thank you for what you did, though I will say it was a strain on our marriage for a little.
That it was. I didn't want to let the birds out, and she said chickens weren't meant to be cooped up. Of course, I said the definition of coop is a place you keep chickens.
Finally, we came up with a compromise that worked for both of us and, more importantly, made the chickens happy. We don't let them run free, but we let them do the next best thing. Run races.
First of its kind. Though I expect it'll catch on. Gives the chickens an outlet for their aggression and allows us to maintain security and control.
Gotta keep those chickens on lock.
It's very simple. I speak to Horace by the track. All profits go to, well, mostly they go to buying more feed. They're voracious eaters.
Okay. Feathered Avenger.
Mr. Cluckles comes from a long line of chickens who...
Let's battle it, yeah.
Mr. Cluckles, you're looking at tail feathers now. There's the Colonel. He even makes losing look good. Mostly Slow Joe now trails. Well, everyone.
So we win the quest whenever we do.
And there's Mr. Cluckles. Your winner.
That was a very safe bet, so we're not getting much.
Blame
I mean, thought we'd be safer killing them all. Then part of me just thought it'd be fun killing loads of chickens.
Cool, but now it's just a recurring quest.
Ah, hello.
Oh, so we have him. Nothing else in Mistpeak. I'm gonna save the game for a bit. The voice is also something that we can't really do kidnapped. We can do kidnapped.
It seems to me that the most certain way to gain followers is to impress them
or,
with your strength.
Yeah, let's just go ahead and finish off Maxis. And our gun still isn't quite ready.
Oh, that Max. He's always getting me into trouble. We were going to go right home after the party, but now he's gone off. I've got to find him.
Well, let's go find
Wonderful.
His brother.
Now, I do kind of know where he is. Follow me.
Ooh, this party looks like it was great.
Mum always warned us about drinking. It was quite sweet, actually, her concern. She used to say, touch that stuff and you'll end up a worthless, filthy old tramp, like your father.
Oh my gosh, is that not?
We always respected her wishes in that regard, which is actually a bit uncharacteristic for us. But Max, he just started putting it away. And all the time he's reading out incantations from the book, laughing like a maniac. He turned the trees upside down, it was raining handbags at one point, and then he summoned this huge, flaming demon who was amazing at croquet. And there were weird bits as well. I told him he should lay off, and he said if I didn't like the party, I could leave. And I said, why don't you leave? And he left. And he took the party with him. Here, I'll just get inside. So, if you just turn into a wisp, you can fly right in... Oh, sorry. Stupid of me. Here.
Hey.
He's in there somewhere. I'd go with you, but I think...
We get to go into the ossuary.
Good luck.
Who needs the living? They're a bunch of wet blankets. Hey! Have you come to join? Hey, what are you
come
doing?
Come on.
I know what this is about. You can't make me go back. Watch this. Whee!
Cool. So what the searchlights will do is they'll just summon Holloman.
I think you'll find this is a barrel of laughs.
We are stuck. Yeah, okay. So they will start saying, hey, we're not paying rent. Not the worst thing, but yeah, we need rent. These businesses are going to help us out, but for right now, let's just worry about the houses. Oh, okay. I don't think you can actually adjust everything until you take over Albion. So you'll notice right now I am not adjusting the rent to give me more good boy points because, well, as of now, I'm pretty much max good anyway. But also because we really need the money. Really, really need the money. Cool. Everything should be good now. I'm actually going to activate the searchlight because I do need to kill more Holloman so I can hopefully upgrade this gun. Continuing after is it Max or Sam? This is Max. Sam is a good boy. We are veterans.
Keep up.
No joke, the ossuary is one of the cooler areas in this game. Nothing. So you may have noticed the golden door over there. I That is another thing that we have to worry about. Ravens. The Raven Queen doesn't like us messing up here. We're gonna try our best to keep up with them. Okay, so this is like the big final battle.
You really are a party pooper, just like Mum. She never lets me do anything. It's always cut that out and put that down, and you'll unleash an ancient evil again. Well, I've had enough of her oppression. I've had a taste of real freedom now. And ale, by the way, which was quite nice.
Ale's well. Good.
I didn't want to kill you. But if it's a choice between that and going back to Mum, you forced my hand!
Oh, at I think it's the fourth level of the guys. You get those nice little finishers.
I'm doing my own thing, and no one's gonna stop me.
Second area.
Some pressing matters to attend to.
Yeah, that ceiling's falling down. That's great.
I hope you enjoy big, piercing, spiky things crushing your head. Right, admittedly, that last one.
And there's nothing we can do. This is how we die. Love it. Oh, hello. It really did. I one hit killed it.
But I mean, killing you like this, that crosses a line. Just look at this situation. You're trapped in a room, spikes start coming down out of the ceiling, and actually, they're moving quite fast, aren't they? They were much higher when I came in. I mean, you might only be seconds away from death, and... Sorry! There. I think that stopped them. Go on, then.
Shwink. Ooh, yeah, we get lots of the searchlights. And they're going really fast, too. Let's hit them all. Once again, I am trying to hit all these to spawn more hollows. Treasure. Oh boy. The health potion, that's actually going to be very helpful. Alright, so this is every encounter that we could have had. Cool, racking up our hollow men and just regular enemies killed. So you notice there are protective wisps in front of the Normanomicon. It gives you a nice clue on what we're supposed to be doing. Simon's a good boy. He won't betray us.
Go on then. Have a drink.
Well, maybe just a teeny one.
Well, how do you feel?
I feel like Mum would never have let me do that. But what's she going to do? Kill me? I can do whatever I like. Watch this!
No, Sam. Sam is a good boy. So this is the Bower Stone. Bower Stone Market theme from Fable 2. Not the first one. Gotta love that walk animation. Still loving the slow motion animations. Use all of them. Hey, we got the book. Well, you see, what had happened was...
Accept this advice. Don't have your children buried near you. Especially if they're anything like mine.
Sorry, we're kind of royal, so we kind of have to.
If I may say so, madam, you have succeeded most admirably in gaining a large measure of popular support among the locals. I believe this would be a good time to return to that rather dreary hole that your new...
So I'm probably not going to advance the plot during this stream. I will just... I'll get 5 more guild seals so I can unlock the melee. Next melee level. And keep buying real estate. Okay, so this does count as a return to the ossuary. Because apparently the ritual was a physical place. So since we came back on a return trip, we can hunt the gnomes and everything that's supposed to be here. And keep encountering Holloman. I should be over in this area.
Excuse me, have you had the time to get stuffed?
There we go. Alright, so we got 10 of them. I guess we can get something from them. I don't think there's anything left here to do. And I don't think it's nighttime in Thornwood proper either. But I can't do it. I can't do it after, not yet. Barrowstone got really big, by the way.
It seems to me that the most certain way to gain followers
is to impress them with your strength and determination by completing quests. But that's just my opinion.
Yeah, let's go back to Brian. Treasure. Oh, nice. We do have enough silver keys to start opening these. Damn. That is not a small amount of gold. Alright, so we should be able to fully buy Dweller Camp now. Yeah, we're not adjusting prices. Hey, that actually gives us a lot to play with. Can't buy anything at the mercenary camp. I guess let's buy stuff in Morningwood. These houses are not in the best condition. Repair all those. The fact that you don't have to go to each individual house and do this is great. Definitely one of the better improvements. We don't have that. I guess we can buy the stalls in Brightwall.
If you could round up those loathsome gnomes that Brian unleashed, you'd really be doing the world a favor.
All right, I'm broke again, but that's fine. Here we are. Dun, 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 dun.
Thank you for finding so many of my little ones. If only I could stand to be around them. It's getting worse out there. I've stopped going out. But we are making good progress. Here.
I got a thing. Harlequin makeup. Lovely. That'll probably help out with the guy who wants us to be ugly. Any second now, we should get a shitload of money. You just sell a bunch of shit. Let's do that.
us there.
Yeah, so these are trade items. Literally all we can do is sell.
Always happy to buy your unwanted items. That's a fine item. Arse. I can't afford to buy that right now. Try me again in a few days.
Two Wings Timmy is the winner!
Two Wings Timmy.
Welcome to the...
Free real estate. We're broke again. That's going to be a cycle that we're going to keep hitting. Hey, we're not broke anymore. Yeah, so it's based on how many minutes I actually have the game open. As opposed to, like, how long has passed during the game. So, we're going to be... in that cycle often.
All right, just what I wanted.
Take
Always
me a
look out for sales.
What can I do? Let's actually go back to the mercenary camp. Ooh, wait, no. I know exactly what we need to do. We need to go into that other cave. So we went inside one of the Chill Breath cabins. We need to go into the other. The trail will not do us any good. Okay, so we've been officially knocked out. Death count. Looks like my death counter doesn't work, that's fine. There we go. I have a button for that now. Specifically for when my mods are away.
Oh,
So we're trying to enter the caverns and start from up here. We haven't been this way since the gnomes started appearing either. I don't think. Check the map one more time. Not that this map is accurate. Okay, so it was actually on the other side of further down there. Oh, neat, this is actually new. Cool stuff. That's acceptable. So these are the caverns where we got the little girl. Do I have enough to... Yes, I do. Okay. Yeah, so right now we have enough to go get the last upgrade on the Road to Rule, the melee weapon one. So we're gonna go ahead and get that, and that's probably where I'm gonna end the stream. I don't actually want to progress the plot. Well, there's no one in chat. That's fine. I'll be back next week with this. Should be a little bit more regular programming. What this is. That looks fucking awesome. But yeah. I certainly had fun, and I'm glad that this was mostly a filler episode, because, I mean, everyone needs that every now and then. yeah, for those of you watching in Archives Land, thanks for joining me. There's no one to say goodbye to chat, or there's no one in chat to say goodbye to, but yeah. Thanks for stopping by, not live, and I'll see y'all later.